Hello guys, this is Sonam. Today in this video I am going to show you how to convert a string to float format. So that means we will initialize a string value and then we will convert this to a float format. So in our last video I have shown you how to convert a string for value to a array format. So if you don't know how to convert a string value to the array format, and please I recommend you to go to that links once, and you can get these links from the description list and you can get idea how to convert a string value to the array format. So let's see how I just created this flow, and this is the view of my button flow. So in this we can convert a string value to the float format. So basically I just created a button flow where I just trigger the flow manually, then initialize, and using a initialize variable action I just initialize a string variable, then converted the string variable to float using some specific expression, and that function is available in the Power Automate. And so let's see how to work with this from the beginning. So here I just log in my office ID in office.com and then click on the sign in, and then it will ask me to insert the email address. So I'm just inserting my email address and password and then click sign in. Okay, now my office ID is login with the office365.com and Microsoft 365, and once it will open the home page, let's go to that app launcher, and here you can get the Power Automate application. And if you don't find it here, then you can go to that all app section, and here you can find all the application that integrated with the Microsoft 365. Then let's go to that open in new tab. Once it will open the Power Automate, then go to the create section. Here we can create all the flows that we want, but for now I just want to create an instant cloud flow. You can click on the instant cloud flow, then click here and then give a flow name and then select the manual trigger. So suppose I'm giving the flow name that convert string to a float, and then manual trigger flow, then click on create. After a while we can see that the trigger is added to the flow, and now here we will add the logic action to the flow. So for now we just click on the new step, and first we will initialize a variable, so string variable. As we convert the string variable string value to the float format, so first we just need to initialize a string variable. So for this, let's click on that action that initialize variable. So click here, initialize variable, and give a variable name of var value, and type should be the string, and give a value, suppose, okay, just close it. Give a value, suppose I'm giving 12.53 is a string value. I am giving the float value in a string format, and then that means it is now a string value. Then after the logic, it will convert the string value to the float format. So I am just rename that action, initialize a string variable, then click on new step, and here I am just giving a compose action where we will insert the expression to convert the string variable to the float. And in quotes we will give some expression, suppose, okay, let's hide this, and okay, expression, give expression, then float, and close the parenthesis, dynamic content and variable value. Okay, now click on okay. Now it's added, and that's it only. Okay, rename this action, convert string to float. Okay, let's test this and click on manually, then test, and click on run, and after a while now it's showing that your flow is ready, and it's showing that flow ran successfully. That means we successfully converted the string variable to the float. So here it is a string variable that we have initialized. So as it is a string value, so it's come in a black color, you can see this. And once it is converted to the float, let's see whether it is converted to the float or not. Yeah, this one is now converted to the float. Okay, it is showing that float or not. No, it's not. But yeah, as it is converted to the float, so it's coming in a green color. So we can distinguish that whether it is a string or float. So that's the advantages of Power Automate. We can see whether it is the value is converted the string or the float. as it is a string, so it's coming in black color, and as it is converted to the float value, so it is coming in green color. So this is how we can convert a string value to a float format. So I hope guys you like this video, and if you get ideas from this video and like this video, please subscribe to our channel for more free videos, tutorials on SharePoint, online, Power Apps, Power Automate, Power BI, Python and machine learning and many more. Please subscribe to our channel and share it as more as you can. You can share these ideas to your colleagues and friends to get them know how to convert a string value to a float. And I hope you like this video. Thank you so much. Have a nice day. Thanks for watching.